Hardwell. 23 is Corey Hitchcock. The second 11 is Kip Sawyer. The 31, Brad Siegel. The blue 7, William Overby. Correction, driving the 51 is Matt Henderson. 51 is Matt Henderson. Around the outside goes the 23 of Hitchcock, getting around the 11 of Cardwell. Up the third spot, the 31 of Brad Siegel. Now diving on the inside of 51 of Matt Henderson. The 23 of Hitchcock now streaks away with a 5-curling lead over the 11 of Cardwell. Then it's the 31 of Siegel. Here comes the 51 of Henderson. Once again, starting on the pole in tonight's 30 lap feature in the limited late models will be last week's feature winner. That's the 23 of Corey Hitchcock. Row number one, will it be the 30 of Ryan King, the 29 of Rusty Ballinger, 23 is Lane Whipple, 2 Mitchell Childress, 26 Brandon Gardner. Of Mitchell Childress, 23 Lane Clifford, 26 is Brandon Gardner. Thank you. starting on the front row tonight in the 30 lap feature in the limited late model. Oh my goodness, what kind of show are we going to have tonight? Inside row number one will be the 23 of Corey Hitchcock. And on his outside will be the 30 of Ryan King. And if you know about 411 Motor Speedway, that's two of our finest. Once again, up on the flag stand, waving the purple flag, representing the fight against Alzheimer's, Lynn Palmer. Next time by, we're going green on the points, the 23 of Corey Hitchcock, the 30 of Ryan King. Once again, a very special shout out and thank you to Richard and Tammy Ford with Speedway Videos, allowing us to confirm the recent winner in the Thunder and Lightning. Start Ryan King, 23, Corey Hitchcock. Then it's the 29 of Rusty Ballinger is the 31 of Siegel. Slides in turn two, bringing out a caution. Caution on the Speedway. It's the 11 of Jason Cardwell. Nose to tail for the lead is Ryan King and Corey Hitchcock. Five car lengths back to the 11 of Cardwell. Five car lengths back to the 31 of Siegel. Now the battle for fourth between Siegel and Ballinger. Rusty Ballinger, the 29, gets underneath the 31 of Siegel, battling for fourth spot. Running identical laps, about 14 and a half seconds around this 3/8 dirt oval. Then it's five car lengths back to the 11 of Jason Cardwell. Great battle for fourth between the 31 of Siegel, the 29 of Ballinger. Sixth spot is the deuce of Mitchell Childress. Up to seventh, the 51 of Matt Henderson. Battle for the lead. The 23 of Hitchcock taking a look underneath the 30 of Ryan King. Coming up on lap traffic, that will allow the 30 to slide off and slam the door in turn three. As the 11 of Sawyer slides over in the infield, bringing out a caution. Caution on the Speedway. Up on the flag stand with that purple flag, Lynn Palmer, indicating to the leader. That's the 30 of Ryan King. Next time by, we're going green. Eight on the board, 22 to go. Correction, going purple. Caution on the Speedway. Caution on the Speedway. The 11, Cardwell, trying to get underneath. Battling for second spot. Bringing out a caution. Caution on the Speedway. As everyone can tell, the 11 of Cardwell, the caution car, going to the rear of the field. Might make it a little resting. Climbing through. Once again, 8 on the board. Once again, on the start is the 30 of King. This time, the 23 of Hedgecock clears the lower traffic. Now he sets his sights on the leader, Ryan King. 23, Corey Hedgecock, up to third, the 31 of Brad Siegel. Fine battle for fourth between the two of Childers, the 29 of Russell D. Ballinger. And up to fifth spot now, the 51 of Matt Henderson. The 11 of Sawyer spins coming out of turn number four, bringing out a caution. Caution on the Speedway. Again, purple flag in the air. Allowing the 30 of Ryan King. This time it is the 23 of Corey Hedgecock sneaking underneath, coming out of turn number two. They dive side by side into three, and at the flag stand it's going to be Corey Hedgecock. Ryan King in the 30 says, not so fast, my friend. He spins around on the upper groove, coming out of turn number two. It appears that the 11 of Cardwell will retire his racer. Tough night for the Cardwell Brothers racing team tonight. Meanwhile, there's a great battle for the lead between the 23 of Hedgecock and the 30 of Ryan King. Drivers are driving identical speeds, identical laps each and every corner around this 3/8 dirt oval. This time it's the 23 of Corey Hedgecock. He will take the lead away from the 30 of Ryan King. Gets in front of the leaders. That's the 26 of Gardner. But the 23 of Hedgecock and the 30 of Keene work their way around. This time by will be 17 on the board with 13 to go for your leader, the 23 of Corey Hedgecock. Of Hedgecock now steals away at the four car length lead over the 30 of Ryan King. Up to third spot is the 29 of Rusty Ballinger. All the way up to fourth now is the 51 of Matt Henderson, gets around the 31 of Brad Siegel. marker on the board for the leader, the 23 of Hitchcock, as the 2 of Mitchell Childers spins out right in front of the leader, but the leader, Hitchcock, gets around, bringing out a caution. Caution on the Speedway. After cleaning up from 2013 late models 100th caution, next time by with 23 on the board, 7 to go. Leader 23, Corey Hitchcock, 30, Ryan King, 29, Rusty Ballinger. Matt Henderson in the 51 takes a look on the outside of 29, Rusty Ballinger. Your leader 23, Hitchcock, steams out with a 4 curling lead. 24 on the board, 6 to go. Second place runner 30, Ryan King. Actually, the 31 is single, gets around the 51 of Henderson, battling for fourth spot. White flag for the 23 of Corey Hitchcock. He's right behind the 26 of Gardner. Keeper straight, Brandon.
Hey, boy, Corey. I tell you what, Corey, let's go on down a little bit further.
It hurts come down here. So we're throwing these on down here a little bit further and chat with tonight's winner in the limited late model one more time, the 23 of Corey Hitchcock. Congratulations, Corey. A little early, I was sort of in humor chatting about him and Ryan elbow to elbow ran through here taking up money for Alzheimer's. And then lo and behold, what I know that they start on the front row and side by side for 10 laps. But on one of those restarts, about lap 11 or 12, Corey, you checked out. Walk us through the first 10 laps and you and Ryan, and then as you checked out with a pretty comfortable lead and win for the last 20 laps.
Ryan's a real good racer. We never have any problems, real clean, so I was going to run him real clean. Car was working a lot better on the bottom than I thought it was going to work out. I thought it was going to be a train race, but I mean, actually, it was pretty racy. Good job to Mitch and everything for making the racetrack good and everything, but thanks to all my sponsors and Scotty Evans for once again giving me this motor and all my sponsors from front to rear, too many to name, but most importantly, my mom, dad, Mike, who couldn't be here tonight, girlfriend, Katie, everyone who helps. I appreciate every one of y'all.
All righty, Corey, before you go, we're going to visit with this young man down here in just a minute, but you've had one heck of a summer, especially here in the mountain. How many wins, features, does that get for you here in the mountain included? I'm going to say it's close to 10. That's just a wild guess.
No, I think it's I think it's either five or six here, but I think we got eight total. So honestly, it's been a great year compared to last year, and yeah, just hopefully we can continue to keep this thing going on. And appreciate y'all clapping for me.
All right, and one more time, tonight's winner in the Limited 8 model, once again, the 23 of Corey Hedgecock.